Cottbus, a small town in the German Democratic Republic, is one of their great centers of excellence for gymnastics. And each year in April, it hosts one of the great gymnastics invitation events, the International Masters. The overall competition has already been decided. And today on Eurosport, we're going to see the highlights of the individual apparatus finals. With me, Monica Phelps, former British champion. Monica, these should be very interesting because they're bringing in the new ruling where every gymnast starts on an even keel instead of carrying through their mark from the overall.
Yes, it's very interesting because that means the gymnast has a fresh start. They can forget mistakes and they can really throw all risk to the wind. And in the individual apparatus finals, we have Laurie Strong from Canada. She's on vault first and she has two different vaults from the C category, the most difficult category. She starts with a Yurchenko with a full twist.
Laurie Strong went into the Olympic Games as the Canadian number one, didn't have a really good competition, finished 36th. In the individual apparatus finals, as Monica was saying, the rules governing the competition change. They have to do two different vaults, and those are then average. 9.725 for her first vault. Now she must do a different vault, and it does put a good test on the gymnast. Some gymnasts specializing just in one vault, they've now got to find two.
Yes, this is a real test for their skill, the variety of vaults that they can produce, and I think this is an excellent rule. Here, the second vault, hoping that she'll choose something entirely different, and she has a handspring, 1.5 front somersault tucked. It was long and rather low, but that should give her a pretty good average score. There's the handspring face. She was a little bit too high onto the handspring, therefore that caused her to plop off rather than fly off. There's the score, 9.6 for the second.
An average of 9.622. Now normally you'd have to add that to the vault she's carrying through, but that's the standard as it is now, 9.622. And Brandy Johnson, the overall champion, in sparkling form. Full twisting Yurchenko. Held her position really well, but it might have been a little low off the top of the horse.
Yes, came in a fraction short. We'll have a look here in slow motion. There's the Arab spring, cartwheel with a quarter turn. A little bit under-rotated, but beautiful form. The step forward will cost her a tenth.
This gives you a flavour of the small-town atmosphere here in Cottbus. No electronic scoreboards even. Brandy Johnson now with her second vault. It is quite remarkable the way that this tournament attracts the best from all over the world.
These Germans have a tremendous track record in Olympic and world standard gymnastics. I spent there 3 months there myself in the 60s, a tremendous place. And there's Brandy's second vault, handspring, 1.5 somersault, pike with a half twist on the end, and it was an excellent vault.
What a competition she's having. Tenth in the overall championship in the Olympic Games. And again, almost step perfect there on that second vault. 9.9 she scores, she takes the lead, 9.768. And perhaps the only person who can beat it, Valerie Kiss from Hungary.
Hungarians doing very, very well to feature in an individual apparatus final, especially on vault. They don't hold such a good record on vault. Nice one. Handspring, 1.5 French somersault pike, the same as Brandy's, but without the half twist.
Bit slow on the runway, but gets good height off the top of the horse. Tremendous.
Yes, she really squeezed that pike in because she was slightly under-rotated. And this really is where the mobility of the gymnast is all important, because they can save a mistake.
The numbers you can see being posted there, that 361 is the number of the next vault she's going to do. There's her score, 9.812. We're getting into the thousandth there because there are six judges, and the middle four scores, which will actually be single figure scores. The judges will be giving 9-8s, 9-9s, so forth, then being divided up four ways.
Valerie's second vault, a packed full twisting Sukahara. Puck is the shape shown through the somersault where they're twisting and tucking at the same time.
And she really is slow, isn't she?
Extremely slow, but amazingly strong from the top of the apparatus. Scores being prepared, no electronics, and 9.65 for her second vault.
And that gives her the silver medal, 9.731, her average. But at the moment, there's nothing to stop. Brandy Johnson from the USA won the overall competition in tremendous style, and now adds a second goal to that, 9.768. Her total, Valerie Kiss second, and Laurie Strong from Canada takes the bronze.
Brandy Johnson, only 16 years old, really on spectacular form. The form that got her the top scorer in the American team in Seoul.
The second final, the asymmetric bars. Camelia Mindrichel from Romania, just 13 years old. The Romanians, of course, the world champions, and then lost out to the USSR in the Olympics, but really right back at the top of their powers.
Yes, they really do blood them into these competitions at a young age, preparing them for world European championships. So they visit the international circuit and get themselves known amongst the judges.
Her face there, a little bit reminiscent of Aurelia Dobre, the world champion.
Holding the standard of the Romanian team with a bar routine like that.
Antje Wilkenlo from the German Democratic Republic, another new face, and the East Germans have really undergone major surgery. None of the familiar names around still in their team, their prospective team for the Worlds and for the Europeans. Everybody gone from the team that competed in the Olympics, apart from Dürte Tummler.
Yes, Dürte, the slender 16-year-old, I think they've only remaining performer in the team, and the other youngsters are being putting out onto the field for test. But Antje here, a good start there with a forward giant into a Jaeger. The East Germans have a tremendous reputation on the asymmetric bars. Maxi Gnauk winning in America. Fabulous stuff there.
And 9.65, that puts her in the silver medal position at the moment. And a very restrained reaction from the huge crowd here in the Cottbus Town Hall. Normally, the East Germans very vociferous in their support. Brandy Johnson next up.
Yes, just a word of advice from coach, and she's obviously in a listening mood with the success so far. And Laurie Strong preparing the asymmetric bars for her, chalking them up or wetting them down. Gymnasts very finicky about how they have their bars.
Everything now to her satisfaction. Normally one of Brandy Johnson's teammates would have been working for her, but when you're away in a far-off foreign country on an invitation international, you grab any help you can. And a Canadian is nearly an American.
The girls can use the Reuter board, which is generally the one of the main parts of the vault apparatus, as a means of mounting onto the bar, but the coach will have to whip in and pull it out so it doesn't get in the way of her feet when she does her giant circles. There into the Kachev from the giant circle, and a lovely inward somersault there
And that 10th place in the Olympic Games really has been the springboard for Brandi Johnson's gymnastics to take off. She's producing very stylish, very difficult stuff, and a beautiful landing there on that double back dismount.
Well, it's not often that gymnasts show their delight at their performance because they train so long and so hard, but a very high catch-up. Coach just being allowed to step onto the podium to support in case. And there, that high inward somersault to re-catch. The skill on asymmetric bars is travelling over and under both bars.
And it's a third gold for Brandi Johnson. The overall and now two individual apparatus finals, and she's in the two still to come.
Am Stufenbein beim 13. internationalen Turnier der Meister Cottbus 1989 wurde mit.
And what success for America! Brandi Johnson into her third gold medal of the event. The overall first, the vault, and then taking with style the asymmetric bar title. Camilia Mindrichel from Romania coming in second, and Dantia Vilkenlo from East Germany third.
Well, the USA have been looking for a golden girl to take the place of Mary Lou Retton, who won gold for them in the 1984 Los Angeles Olympics. It looks as if they've found one now. Join us again in a couple of minutes for the other two women's finals. After that, the men's. Welcome back to the International Masters Tournament from Cottbus. At the moment, nobody can touch Brandi Johnson from the USA. Won the overall competition, has won the first two individual finals, and now favorite as well to win the beam. Up early in the final, the order in which they go drawn. What can she do here? The most testing piece in the women's competition.
Yes, generally gymnasts, whilst they're performing, there are other activities going on other pieces of apparatus, but during the individual apparatus finals, it's a silent arena and they're up there on their own. And it's extremely silent on beam. Everybody in the audience has the urge not to breathe.
In the overall competition, Brandi Johnson 9.75. That's the highest score on beam we've seen. And although she doesn't carry that mark through with her, it must give her confidence to know that she's capable of getting a higher mark from the other competitors.
She's landing her tumbles with supreme confidence. She had a back tumble and then a forward tumble, a somersault forwards, which is a blind landing. Again, a back. So far, not even a tenth wobble.
And a lovely, very fast double back somersault there. Getting out of it early, able to land perfectly. She really cannot put a foot wrong at the moment.
No, it's a fabulous feeling when you're on song, and Brandi Johnson is truly on song, because on beam, here we see the back tumble, flick-flack, followed by a straight back, and she knows every inch of the beam and just not a murmur.
9.75 in the overall, 9.85. She's thrown down the gauntlet. Laurie Strong now from Canada scored 9.4. The first time she competed on beam in this event. Nerve-wracking moment for her.
Like Brandi, Laurie, only 16 years old. Her last major championship in Seoul, a bit of a catastrophe. She was expected to be their top scorer, but just squeezed into the top 36 and didn't manage to make an apparatus final.
trains under a Russian coach, Leonid Gravkovsky, from Whitby in Ontario.
Each year sees more difficulty on beam, and in the next few years we're going to see many more tumbles linked together. Now the skill is not in individual elements, in the days when Olga Corbett did her famous tuck back, but now almost tumbling runs. One, two, three, four moves linked together.
Two consecutive split leaps. They don't look that difficult in comparison to some of the other gymnastic skills, but they're very difficult on beam to get good extension in the leap and to land perfectly, as she did. Very difficult indeed. The double back, not as high as Brandy Johnson, but a good exercise there from Laurie Strong.
This is a particularly nice combination because it was a straight back onto one leg, straight into a Corbett flick. And that is very difficult indeed. She came down a little unsquare, must have been uncomfortable. 9.55, a good score though.
Maria Neculiță from Romania. This little tiny waif showing incredible confidence. Won the silver medal in the overall competition. And all the big gymnastics countries at the moment, Monica, blooding their new talent, putting them out there into the invitation internationals to see how they stand up to the big events. What a combination that was from her.
Well, I think that the coach knows that they can train the body of the individual, they can teach the moves, prepare the body for strength, providing it has the correct build, but what they can't do is train the brain, only find out how they can cope with the pressure in the stress of competition. Stolen that out of Aurelia Dobre's book. The intricate little turns like that that take many, many months to perfect. They're just as difficult as the tumbles in their own way.
Building up now to the final run down the beam and the dismount. Beautiful stuff from her, tremendous work. Maria Neculiță. Flick flack. Straight back somersault, straight back somersault, lovely combination.
And a brilliant score at only 13 years old, 9.75. Antje Vilkenhoe from East Germany. A totally different build from the little waif from Romania. A very powerful girl. And a powerful mount front somersault onto the end of the beam. Difficult.
Got it right that time in the overall competition. Came off there. Now she's really got the sort of start she needs for a big score. Lost 0.5 in the overall. And still scored 9.225, so she certainly has the difficulty in the routine.
Beam only 4 inches wide, 16 feet long, and it has a suede covering, so it has an anti-slip surface. And it's only in the last decade that it's had a cover on it, and the edges are barreled, so that it makes a little easier for the gymnasts to grip in handstands.
Well corrected, but definitely had to adjust the balance there. That'll be a tenth away.
The routine lasts for 1 minute and 35 seconds, and it's up to the gymnast how much she can cram into that. That was a triple twisting back somersault, only just to dismount.
Yes, 2 3/4, she was still a little bit sideways on as she came out of it, but a super exercise from Antje Vilkinlo. And a very restrained crowd again. Polite applause, the order of the day in Cottbus.
And a second look at her mount, a front somersault to land firmly on 2 feet. Really an excellent routine and an excellent score, 9.75.
And that took her to joint second with Maria Nekulica. But once again, nobody can touch Brandi Johnson from the USA, a girl from Brown's Gymnastics Club in Florida. Confirmation there, joint second, Nikolica and Vilkinlo.
And Brandi Johnson on truly magnificent form. She hasn't put a foot wrong in this competition so far. All round gold and 3 individual golds.
Got to start at this stage to wonder whether she can make a clean sweep of it. One of the great achievements in gymnastics, one that every gymnast goes for. Clean sweep, 5 golds. Can Brandi Johnson do it? We'll be back to see in a couple of minutes. Welcome back to the Cottbus International Masters and the final section of the women's competition, the individual floor final. Can Brandi Johnson make a clean sweep of it? This is certainly going to be her toughest test. 3 girls outscored her in the overall competition. One of them, this girl, Oksana Shusevitina from the USSR. Another new face to me, Monica.
Yes, the Soviets keep throwing up this new talent. Obviously a testing ground for her. Most of the gymnasts here are being tried for their nations teams for the European Championships, which are to be held next month. But Oksana looks a trifle too young, but not too young to perform that magnificent double straight, followed by the double back. What skill!
Just shows the breakthrough there's been in women's gymnastics in the last few years. Any male gymnast would have been more than proud of that just 4 years ago, but now you've got this little waif of a gymnast opening up with double straight, going straight back with double tuck and a punch front out of it.
It's interesting, John, though, in the last, well, since Seoul, Larshinova, who was the best tumbler in the Russian team, had extremely powerful legs, and this little one has too. It looks as though they're designing their gymnasts to be powerful tumblers as well as exquisite dancers.
Again, not content with just the double back, working out of it. What a good exercise there.
And it was just so packed with difficulty. And for such a youngster, only 14 years old, able to produce double straight back somersaults like that, and then return across the floor to do double backs, she might well be puffed out. 9.75, an amazing score and an amazing routine.
Well, that's the standard that the others know they have to beat. 9.75. to go with the 9.725 that she scored in the overall competition. Now Brandi Johnson. She certainly got to go better than she did in the overall. She scored 9.7 then. And she's going to need something very special to beat Shusevitina.
Already Johnson showing a maturity in her dance. Full in, back out, that's 2 somersaults with a full twist in the first and a piked exit.
How about that, Monica? A tremendous middle tumbling run with two whips and a double back on the end of it, and then lots of height for the final 1-2. What style from her?
Brilliant stuff. I'm sure that she's got Shusevitina there. She had much better dance. The tumbles equaled her Russian rival, and I'm sure that'll win the gold.
Well, she wasn't performing feats like that in the Olympics. At that stage, she was just good. Now she's brilliant.
It was an exhausting routine, John, and she hardly looks tired. 9.8, yes, she must have done it.
Looks like 5 out of 5 for Brandy Johnson, a thing the gymnasts dream of, but rarely ever achieve. The great Ludmila Tereshova did it in the World Cup back in the 60s. Mustn't prejudge, though. Maria Neculitsa from Romania, and we've seen that she's so talented, she could still stop that clean sweep. Full in back out from her. But it was a little flat after the spring that we saw from Brandy Johnson.
Yes, and Brandy really has everything to go for because she's feeling so good. She's all got a lot of energy because she's got a lot of adrenaline after her success so far. An effort to work out of the double back and return across the floor. And Nicolita showing some good tumbling, but very immature dance in comparison to Johnson. So I'm sure that Johnson must have pipped her. Here, some very tight tumbling, the flick-flack into the whip back and building up for the high double back, but not managing to go straight into the flick-flack, having to stop slightly. Working back across the floor, and this is where Daniela Silivashin's soul popped a punch front somersault on the end. Nicolita not quite ready for that.
Certainly somebody to watch, though. Maria Nicolitsa, 9.712. That gives her third place at the moment. Laurie Strong from Canada.
Plenty of aggression on that opening tumble. strong, producing some good sound tumbles, but having a few minor errors with foot faults and walking out of spins, losing tenths throughout the routine. But extremely powerful on this, her middle tumble, which was a 2.5 twister into a punch front. The step back there, though, costing her perhaps at least 2/10. And Laurie Strong, as every gymnast does, thinking what could have been if she hadn't made those minor errors. But it's over now, and all she can do is sit and wait and see how favourably the judges will look upon the routine. And there's the score, 9.712, and that takes her in equal third for the moment.
Camelia Mindrichel from Romania. This probably the last gymnast who could have an effect on the medals, but she could still take gold, scored 9.75 in the overall competition. That was equal top score with her compatriot Maria Nikolitsa. Foot out there. She's now being marked out of 9.9. That makes it very difficult. Just 13 years old, so she can't take part in the European or the World Championships this year, but already a sensational gymnast.
Mindrichel, typical of all the Romanians, excellent tumbles, perfect body preparation, just a little bit of mood and feeling needed in her dance, but at 13 years old, she's got time for that. Fabulous run of tumbling there, bracing her ankles very strongly on that double back landing.
She's even learned how to smile. One of the things that we criticize the Eastern Europeans for, very often they no show of emotion at all. I think there were too many mistakes for her to get into the medals, but again, somebody to watch for the future.
But even at her tender age, John, very, very keen to see what the judges in another country will give her, because obviously she's not travelled very much, perhaps one of her first major international tournaments.
There it is, 9.637, not quite for her, but a good first invitation tournament. But there, an absolute triumph for Brandi Johnson from the USA. A very rare thing to achieve a clean sweep in any competition, but to do it in a major international invitation event in which there are 32 gymnasts from 18 different countries. One of the things that she'll remember for the rest of her life. Remember, we've got the men's competition still to come. We'll be back in a couple of minutes. Don't miss it here on Eurosport.